Okay, so I'm installing a set of tailgate latches for steel. It's a buyer's kit. Show you what it looks like in the box. So here's a kit that this welds to the truck and holds the screw latch on. And then you got a pin, some washers, and you got this plate here. Alright, so my kit required some modification. As you can see, I had to cut this section off right here because I didn't have enough space between here to get the whole latch in. So here's the latch. This needs to fit in here like this. As you can see, I had to trim it down so I could fit it. So now, what I initially did was I put these where I thought they would work pretty well, and then I measured from the bottom of the tailgate up 7.5 inches, because that's about where it was when I put it. So I made it even on both sides. So then I took a flap wheel on my grinder, and when I held this up here, I marked around it, around all the edges. So I had a mark of where it was going to be. I took a flap wheel and I went about an inch to an inch and a half outside of it. And then did that all the way around. So I did that on both sides. Here's the other side. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to mark this other side. So now that I have it basically where I want it, I'm gonna make sure I got some clearance on the gate. I'll probably set it more to the outside. Make sure it's straight. In the middle. Like I said, give yourself some space off the tailgate. I'll mark this one same way I marked the other one. I'll do that on both sides. All right, so now that I got that done, I'm gonna put the body back up. I'm open up the tailgate so I can get a gap between the door here, and then I'm gonna grind that paint off. So I also like to clean up the edges on here too, where I'm going to be welding. You don't have to go all the whole thing, but I usually do like half an inch or something on each side, or at least the edge. Alright, so I'm gonna go over to the other side and do the same thing.
Alright, so put the gate back down. Put the body back down so I can put the gate up against it. Tack that in place, and then I'll do the same thing on the other side. All right, so now that I got those tack welded where I want, I'm going to take these off and put the body back up so I can weld it in. Kind of rusty bodies and stuff because it's a used all year long, so I make sure your grounds and everything are clean.
So
there's a weld. That's all right, but generally you want to weld around the corners because the corners are a point of stress. So if you don't weld around the corners, I was trying to get around it, but I got stuck up against this. So that's why here I went around as far as I could. And here I went around. So you generally want to go around the corners to keep them from cracking and then breaking off. So it makes like uniform weld instead of a point where it can get ripped off, basically. All right, so I'm gonna do the same thing on the other side. All right, so with these are pretty universal. So there was too much shaft, or too much of the threaded eye here. So what happened was it was hitting this bar right here, and it was just bottoming out, and it wasn't actually tightening down on the tailgate. So I had to take that off and then cut about like an inch off of it. So painted it, put a little paint on there and stuff. So take these. Side of it a little bit because of to get the bracket in there. It's just the way it landed to the outside. Otherwise it wouldn't have fit in there past the gate. So basically that's how you do that. It's pretty self-explanatory, but I figured I made a good video for entertainment purposes. Anyway, hope this helps someone. Thanks for watching.